The purpose of this video is to guide you in your analysis of the 16S rRNA gene sequence of your nature isolate. To do this analysis, make sure you have downloaded the TraceView file from Learn at UW and installed a TraceView application. You may use either 4Peaks for Mac or Finch TV for PC. In this video, I will be using Finch TV, but will still be applicable for those using 4Peaks. To start, open your TraceView file in Finch TV. Immediately, you will see a lot of relevant data. Let us focus first in this top region. In this region, you will see the results of your sequencing, specifically the base sequence of the DNA you submitted. These bases are referred to as base calls, and were determined based on peaks from this chromatogram below, which is this graph consisted of colored lines right here. For example, we can check why at position 30, the base is determined to be guanine or G. When you click on this base, you can see the corresponding signals in this position right here. We can adjust the horizontal scale to look at that peak. And as you can see here at this region, you see only one peak in black. If we check the legend, which is on this top right side, you can see that the color black corresponds to signals for guanine. Therefore, at position 30, the base is likely guanine, or G. There are cases where the base at a position is undetermined. If this is the case, it is designated by the letter N. For example, at position 966, the base call is N. If we click on this nucleotide, we can see that there are two signals, one colored green and the other one colored black. In this case, you arbitrarily choose what base is in this position. Although there are black and also green signals here, the green signal seems to be a continuation of the base of the signal from the previous base. Therefore, the base is likely represented by the black signal, which is guanine. We can then replace N with G. Remember, though, that this part is arbitrary. If we click View, and then from the drop-down menu, we click on Chromatogram Info, we see all the base calls and the sequence of the DNA we submitted. As you can see here, there are some ends in the beginning of the sequence, which is usually the case for most sequencing results. The most important part is checking ends throughout the sequence. And as you can see, there are not a lot of ends throughout. This indicates that our sequence is good and we obtain a good sequencing result. There are cases when we get poor sequencing results. This is an example of a bad sequencing result. If we click on the chromatogram info, you can see that there are a lot of ends or undetermined bases. We can check our chromatogram and see what the peaks look like. At position 68, we can adjust the scale. So we can focus on that region. In this region, we see three peaks. These peaks are also around the same intensity. Therefore, it is difficult to say what this base really is. These poor sequencing results may be because of the sample you sent was not pure, and that there might be other sequences that are messing with your results. Once you have analyzed your chromatogram, you can proceed to check what species your 16S rRNA gene sequence correspond to. To do this, let's go back to our good sequencing result. You can click on the chromatogram info to obtain the actual sequence. Then we can select the sequence and copy it. We can then go to BLAST. If you type in BLAST in Google, this should be the first link that pops up. BLAST is a bioinformatics tool that allows you to compare your 16S rRNA gene to a known 16S rRNA database to determine what bacterial species you likely have as your nature isolate. To do this, click on Nucleotide BLAST. Then in this box, you paste your sequence. This is all we need to do for this part. We can proceed to choose which database to compare our sequence to. You can click on this drop-down menu and choose 16S ribosomal RNA sequences. Finally, we are ready to submit our inquiry by clicking on BLAST. This takes a few seconds and then we'll get our results. So these are the results of our BLAST input. We can scroll down and check what sequences our sequence matched to. This is the description, and then we have the percent identity. Our sequence matched to the 16S rRNA gene of Escherichia fergusoni with 97% identity. The higher this percentage is, the better the match. However, you also see that our sequence matched to the 16S rRNA gene of Shigella boidi with 97% identity, as well as Shigella flexneri, also with 97% identity, Shigella sonii, which is also 97% identity, E. coli at 97% identity, and so on and so forth. This showcases a caveat with sequencing. There are cases where a sequence matches to several sequences, and therefore using sequencing alone won't allow us to conclude the identity of your nature isolate. Sequencing, however, will help narrow down your nature isolate to certain species, but you would have to do other tests to determine your nature isolate. That's it for sequence analysis. Thanks for watching.